Hello there, everyone, and thank you so much for coming back. Today, I'm going to be remodeling the new coffee shop into a house. Recently, I did the newer restaurant that we just got maybe a few weeks ago into a house. That was quite a challenge, but I don't feel like this is going to be a challenge. I think this is just going to be a lot of fun. I already have some ideas about what I'm going to do in here. I love the coffee shop as it is. I think it's beautiful. I think they did a wonderful job this time. Of course, the outside's a little flat, but it is a commercial build, so that's totally understandable that I'm going to try to make this look just like a beautiful house. As for the inside, I have some ideas. I think they did a wonderful job, though, making it into a coffee shop, but I'm thinking about just making this a huge great room. I think it would work really well. If you're new here, I also wanted to let you know when I do remodels, I don't change the walls. I literally just go in and redecorate things. Maybe change a top floor if there's too many or something like that, or take a basement out. But for the most part, I leave it just the way it is. I love every single item that we have gotten with this update. Every single item is beautiful. The only thing I'm a lot disappointed about is that once again, there's beautiful railing in here, but we don't get to keep it. How wonderful would this look with the black chalet staircase? I wish we could just have the railings. I don't understand that at all. But let's shift our focus back to the items and the remodel. I'm thinking about a lofted bedroom up here. And of course, there's the room back there that you just saw. And I'm thinking about a master bath there. I want to do something with the lot in the back, though, because there's nothing there but tables right now. So maybe a garage, we'll have to see. But when I come back, you'll get to see what I have done with the build and how I've turned it into a house. Here it is finished, and I'm so excited. I absolutely love this. First of all, this is definitely my favorite update yet. I just think they get better and better. But I love this house. I can't wait to show you the inside of it. But I did use this as the driveway. I took all the tables out. I put some lights in between the planters, as you'll see here in night mode. So you have, there's the street, and you just drive up the driveway and you see the red car there. I put some lights in between those planters. I did put the garage out back. I didn't really put anything in the garage yet, but there are some garbage bins in there. You'll see that in just a second. There's a barbecue area back here. You'll get a better look at that in day mode, but I just wanted to show you the driveway lit up at night. So let's look at it again in the daytime. This is that patio area back here. I did put some grass there. I took some of that patio off so there'd be some grass back here with the barbecue area. And there's where the car would enter the garage. Again, I just put some trash bins in there, but I wanted to put something back here that made it look even more like a house. And you could even do an upstairs on the garage as well. And you could connect it to the upstairs of the house if you did a two-story garage. Just an idea. But you can definitely remodel this coffee shop into a house without changing a single wall. So let's look at the inside. Turn these lights on. I just think they're beautiful. And you come straight into this huge open concept great room area, as I was talking about in the before. So over here on the left, I have used that as the living area. So the new shelves are on either side of the TV. And look at the wood on the TV, how closely it matches the wood on the new sofas and chairs. I did get that new rug. I think I purchased that in an online pack. But this would just be the area where the Sims would come over and watch TV and relax. I love the little coffee table. I just put a plant over there on the new end table. And I believe I got that lamp as well in an online pack. And I just put that in the corner over there. But look how beautifully this all blends together. I think it just looks wonderful. Again, there is not a single item in this update that I'm not absolutely in love with. And on this side of the room over here, I've just put two of the new green chairs. I think they're really cute. And the hanging plant in the corner, some of the new artwork on the wall. And over here is the dining area. I just love the fact that they can sit there on their computer, though. And I know it's set up as a coffee shop bar, but I think it looks great in a house. It definitely fits really any kind of decor, except for maybe really traditional. It may not work with that. But I love this, more of the rugs over there and one of the planters in the corner. And I did leave the wallpaper the way it was, as well as the flooring. And over here's the kitchen. I used one of the stainless steel sinks and I reconfigured the kitchen. Of course, they had the whole back filled with the service area for the coffee shop, but I just made a C-shaped kitchen. It's perfect for cooking, making coffee, and I love this action where they can do this. I think that's so cool. And then she just brings it over here to the couch and has her coffee. When I tried it again, she actually took it over to the bar and drank it before. But that is the kitchen, and I did use some of the red in the toaster oven as well because there's some of the red in the wallpaper. As far as the wallpaper goes, I have been dreaming of wallpaper like this for years for this game. And then they give it to us in two parts, so you can mix and match it anywhere in the home, and it's just gorgeous. In here, remember, these were two restrooms. On this side, I put the laundry room. It's just big enough for the Sim to come back and do the laundry, as well as some clothing units there, because there really wasn't too much room upstairs for a closet. So I thought it would just be perfect to put the clothing in here, and that way they can just wash it and put it straight away. I actually got that idea from a house I did recently with a huge family laundry room. I don't know if you've seen that or not. Over here on this side is still a restroom, but now it's a home bathroom. So you can see she's standing at the sink there. Look how pretty this looks. I put the toilet divider up, the hotel shower, the hotel vanity. It just looks so pretty. I just love this wallpaper, and it gives me so many decorating ideas. I also do like the brick that you see here and also on the opposing walls in the main floor area right there. I like that too, but that's definitely going to be for more of an industrial type build or something like that. But that flowered wallpaper, I just cannot say enough for that and the ideas that it gives me. So that was the main floor. Now we're going to come up here. Again, changing no walls. All I did was decrease the size of the mezzanine to give me more loft. So now we have this beautiful bedroom up here. Look at this. Look how pretty. I love this. So the new shelves on either side of the bed. We have a table at the foot of the bed, the floor lamps, the hanging lights above. I put one of the hanging chairs over here where she's sitting. You can look straight down there into that big great room area. I left the floor the way they had it. I thought it looked wonderful the way it was. And there's the staircase that we just came up. I put a newer bench over there and a tree in the corner. I wanted to keep some areas simple and then sort of have some areas where there's groupings of items. And I love the record stand so she could just go pick out a record and then come over here to the right where I have actually put two of the chairs there and the record player. So she could just bring the record over here and sit here and listen to music. I wish they had included a record player or something where they took the records over and actually put it in with the update, but they didn't, so I just put the older one in there that we already had in the game. There's another view from that side of the great room area, and then I've set her up a little tiny office area in the corner. And then there's one more room to look at, and that is the master bathroom. I'm kind of excited to show this to you because I was just sitting there experimenting, and I grabbed that, I believe, Villa Gold shower. One of the only type like this that's freestanding. It doesn't have to be against anything. So I just put those in the middle of the room. And then I happened to think about these plant holders that we have. I can't remember the name exactly of what the item is called. And I put them on either side. Look how this turned out and how cool this is. So you can just step right in the shower and on either side you have plants around you. I just think that's really neat how that turned out. I was really happy about it. I'm going to play around a little bit more with it. But yeah, take a look at that. That is so cool. And I don't know what's going on with the glitching underneath and above the new doors and windows that we're placing, but it makes the floors and the roofs glitch. I don't understand that. Hopefully they fix that soon. But the rest of the bathroom, there's the chalet rose gold and black vanity, and then the gold and black tub there. And then I just put a black toilet over there in the corner, put some new hanging lights over the tub. And then I used the flowered wallpaper on opposing walls there as accent walls and used that pretty red color on the other wall. So that is the upstairs of the remodel. We're going to go take a look at where I put everything in case you want to try this. You can very easily go in here and turn this coffee shop into a beautiful house without changing anything other than resizing the mezzanine, which is not changing walls. The walls are already there. Just remember, if you're going to do it without changing the walls and you need to change the mezzanine, leave a strip there. Don't get rid of that railing. You can go in and mess around and make the loft any way you want to, but make sure you leave a piece of that mezzanine railing or you will lose it. So again, there's the garage. You don't really even need to add that, but you can if you want to. It does make for some extra space. But that was the first floor there. Then you come up here and you can see all I did was move up the mezzanine a few spaces to give me some room there for that music area and the office there. And then over to the left a little bit to give me enough space to make the bedroom. So that's one way you could do it, or you could just do it completely opposite. As long as, again, you leave that piece of mezzanine, you can reconfigure that any way you want to. And then there's that master bath where I created that funky looking little shower there, but I think it's so cute. And I had forgotten to mention, as flooring for the shower, I used one of the spa mats in, I believe, the dark finish. So that is the remodel of the coffee shop into a house. I absolutely love this, but if I have to pick something that I love the most about it, would be this great room, because if you've watched my channel for any length of time, you know how challenging it is for me to lay out a large area like this on a remodel. These large rooms really are intimidating for me to lay out for some reason, but when I started doing this, and probably even before, it's almost like I immediately knew how it was going to look ahead of time. I don't know why, but so when I came in here to redecorate everything, it was so much fun. I do really like this bedroom up here too, though. I think it looks gorgeous. I just love the whole house, really. If you enjoyed the tour and you like the house, please let me know by leaving a comment below or hitting that like button. I sure do appreciate it. I hope you did enjoy it. You guys have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.